Hey Jackals, today we'll take a look at the Time Machine plugin for DaVinci Resolve and some of the most common use cases. Now let's get digital. You can download the plugin from this website and I'll leave the description down below, and you can also follow the installation steps, or you can watch my previous video that I'll link on how to do that. To install the plugin, you'll have to go into the Fusion page, so you can make a Fusion composition or you can select a clip. I'll select this clip and go into the Fusion page. To access the Time Machine node, you simply then open the tools and type in Time Machine, but to actually add it, you go to Workspace, Scripts, Reactor and open it. Then just type in the plugin name, this will be Time Machine, and you can add it. I already have it installed, so I'll delete this one and add a new one, Time Machine. And it's added. Now in some cases, this doesn't look like it does now. So just in case, I'll leave this text file. I'll rename this value to 5, Time Machine 5. This is the name of the node. And also rename it here. Then copy this and paste it. This should make it so these buttons will look like this. Let me just show you how it looks like when it breaks. Now in this case, as you can see, the button looks squished and I have no idea how to fix this. But if that happens, and let's say that you want the warp function, when I mouse over it, you can see that it's actually the remap. So if you want the warp function, you have to click to the left of it until it changes, and now you have the warp function. So now let's go back to this example. So some of the most common use cases, let's see, you can use the warp. So with the time warp, you can speed up the animation. We have to select the source end. This is 189. And now if you want to see something, we actually have to keyframe this. So let's just go to the last frame and set this to 1. And set the first frame to 0. So this is how the video looks by default. And now let's say that I want to speed it up, so it won't end at this point, but let's say that it ends somewhere like here, halfway. And now when we play it, the video is sped up. Well, you can slow down the video in this mode, but you can reverse it so it will go from the end to the beginning. So the next mode that you can use is the remap mode. So with the target end frame, this is the last frame that we want the animation to be at. So in a way, you could slow the animation down with the target end frame, but because the video clip is not long enough, it will stop at this point. But you can also speed it up, just like before. The only thing that you need to do is to adjust the source start and the source end to the frames that you want to manipulate. Then the next option that you can use is random. This will randomize all of the frames in the clip, so maybe you can use this as a transition, but don't use it on a whole clip, because it does look spasmy, as you could see. Then you have the hold option, and when I play the video, nothing happens. And that's because the default value is 0, which means that it will hold the 0 frame. So maybe at frame 50, I can keyframe this, and say I want it to hold frame 40, and I need to keyframe the first frame at 0. So you can have the animation and then pause the animation. As you can see with the hold option, you can make a pause go kind of video. So if that's something that you want, the Time Machine node will do just that. Now the next option is skip. This option will take one frame, the current one, and make the number of copies that you select. So let's say that I want to skip 5 frames in total. I'll select 4 copies and the first one, and this will skip a couple of frames. As you can see, it keeps, and if I have 10 frames in total, we'll have 10 frames the same until another one shows up. This also means that the animation won't go all the way till the end, but it does depend on how many frames you have. So if you want to make a choppy style kind of video or just want a choppy effect, this is how you can do it in the Time Machine node. So the offset option is a little bit special. I'm at the beginning of the clip, and if I go left, the clip will go forward in time, as you can see. But if I go to the right, I'll go back in time. Don't believe me? Look at this.
Hello and welcome to Simon Digital.
So it's not exactly possible to go back into the future.
Where is it?
And the last option that I'll cover today is the switch. So let's say that we have the animation and we won't be using this video. We'll just make a mask paint node, a background node, and make a quick little animation with the mask paint node selected and display it on the left side by pressing 1. And with the multi-stroke selected, and let's say I'll go to frame 50, I can make one stroke, second one, third one, fourth one, fifth one, seventh one, eighth one, ninth one, tenth one, and this will be the 11th stroke. And to move one keyframe forward, I just used right arrow key. So now we have this animation, and what we can do in the Time Machine node now, as you can see, nothing shows up in the right side, except this whole thing. So now we can define our beginning animation, which is 50 in this case, and the ending animation, which is so 60. So this is the animation that we have, and what we can do with this animation is we can repeat it easily. So we defined the starting point of the animation, which is 50, and the ending point, 60. Now we can simply go maybe to frame 80 and apply it. But as you can see, we now have 1 all the time, and we don't want that, so we'll go to the beginning, keyframe this, and make it a 2. So now this disappears, and at 80, the animation shows up. And we can repeat the animation at 95, maybe 120, 135, we can also repeat it at the beginning, something like that, just make it the 1. So now if you play this back, we'll see the animation a couple of times on the right side. The only thing that you can do within one Time Machine node using the switch is to have the same animation twice. So this animation is still going on, and if I make the animation here, it will start from the beginning. And that's the only limitation when it comes to repeating the same animation using the switch option. And that's all about the Time Machine plugin for now. If you like this video, give it a thumbs up, subscribe to my channel, and hit the bell notification icon so don't miss my next video. I'm Simon, and until next time, Jackals, keep it digital.